Senator Jambi Madrigal, she's an independent candidate for president. Good morning and welcome to you, Senator.
Good morning, Karen.
All right, I know na you threatened, you were asking for a 100% parallel manual count. If the COMELEC doesn't give it, you will go on hunger strike.
You know, 2 weeks ago, we already could foresee a lot of problems.
Yes.
Even last month, when I was watching the printing of the ballots, the COMELEC, I would call them the denial queen.
Denial queen, okay.
Because at that time, there were problems when they had all the checkers go on lunch break when we were going to check if the ultraviolet was scanning properly.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they were already improperly scanning. But the COMELEC said, Commissioner Larrazabal said, they're on lunch break. It was a 24-hour operation.
Uh-oh.
And we heard from the staff that they just let them out when we were there.
Okay.
So we wouldn't see the glitches.
Yeah.
Marrojas, myself, and Senator Surge, we voted against this manual election.
No, automation.
Automation.
Okay, all
right. We voted against automation when it was passed because we knew there would not be any transparency under a Gloria Macapagal Arroyo government.
Okay.
And now, 5 days before
election.
So you
are not against automation, per se?
I'm not against automation. I'm against a COMELEC which is dirty, which is not transparent, handling the automation. I'm against the Garci president handling automation.
But, you know, a lot of people, especially now on Twitter and Facebook, are now disappointed. They're asking, what's wrong with our country? What's wrong with us Filipinos that other countries can automate? Tayo, we can't seem to move forward, Senator.
Well, what's wrong with it is we don't have the proper preparation. We accepted these Picos machines. And my God, Venezuela, the original automation program was from Canada.
Okay.
Why did we go through a subcontractor? We could have gone to the original Canadian company.
So why did we? I heard because Smartmatic had such, it bidded very low. That's number one. Is that true?
Yes, but are we going to sacrifice our elections for low bidding? I don't even think they bidded low because the technology is not theirs. We're overpaying them for technology that they're just getting. Why not go direct to the source? I don't think they knew, when I met them, I don't think they knew what they were doing.
Now, okay, are you in favor of a postponement?
I have been pushing for a 100% parallel count.
Yeah.
I don't think it is any use to postpone the elections if we can have a 100% parallel count in the precinct. I was cheated heavily in 2004. My precinct results were different from the COC results. So if you can get the precinct count, which is the base count,
okay,
to supersede. Now, if you want to test the machines, why not? Let's see how successful or unsuccessful Smartmatic are.
Okay, now, let's talk about that. You still want us to go into a parallel manual count on the precinct level,
yes,
which would mean per ballot, bawat balota, babalik tayo na tinataras, diba? Yung tawag
yes,
doon.
Yes.
Madrigal, one. Rojas, Juan,
yes.
Ganun ulit.
Yes.
Pero ang balota na gusto po ninyo, yung balotang na-imprenta
well,
na.
Well, we can use the printed ballots and count from there.
Count from there.
Yes.
Now, I interviewed Senator Marrojas here yesterday, and he said the COMELEC is clearly not prepared for a manual count, given, you know, a printing of election returns, folders, everything, I mean, papers.
You know, I've been working on this with Secretary Ernest. Former Secretary Ernie Ordonez.
Okay.
Then he has a different opinion from Marrojas because they even counted how many days it would take. If we did only the presidential, it would take just another 3 days to do the manual count in the precinct with the Board of Election counting it, the teachers themselves counting it. So
it would take an additional 3 days after May 10.
After May 10. That's what Secretary Ordonez. I suggest you have him here.
Okay, okay.
Because he has studied the nitty-gritty. I was just an advocate together with Senator Noynoy, myself and other candidates, the Makati Business Club. We signed that petition.
All right,
pushing
okay.
Pushing for a parallel manual count on the precinct level.
So you feel that given the glitches that the PCOS machines are showing, even if the PCOS machines are there and it's tested properly, you do suggest we still have a 100% parallel manual count along with it?
Why not? Because that would at least confirm whether the machines counted properly or not, and that would be a test run.
Now, James Jimenez of COMELEC during our forum said, the problem with two counts is if they're different, who do you follow? But it doesn't mean the manual can't be cheated. I mean, that's
precinct,
a good point, too.
We are pushing for precinct count.
Okay.
Not the COCs.
So
the COCs are changed.
Yes, yes.
But the raw precinct data, that should be.
It's rarely changed,
yes.
You're saying,
yes. Yes, because that's the original count.
Okay. So you would prefer, now let's say it's different, the results of the PCOS and the precinct manual. What
that
would be the final thing?
The precinct manual would supersede.
That's what you're saying.
Count. Yes.
Yeah, but wouldn't that be against the Constitution now, given that we should be on automation?
Well, we are already against the Constitution because, not the Constitution, we're against the law.
Okay.
Because under the law, there should have been major tests. So we're already going against the law because we are already enforcing automation without testing.
But given where it is going now, do you honestly feel itutuloy ang election o hindi? What
I'm
do you
hoping
see?
Against hope that the elections push through with 100% parallel manual count. That's the ideal.
Okay.
But anything is possible with Gloria's desire to stay in power.
But do you see this as a conspiracy theory? I mean,
I've
seriously?
Always said this, that this would happen. I've always said that COMELEC are not ready. I've always said that they tried to program. Remember, even Remulla now is crying bloody murder because apparently Villar's votes are being given to Guibo Teodoro. So, read my lips.
Okay, read my lips. Go ahead, continue with that thought. I don't want to intrude. I might have my own thoughts, but please continue.
Yes, so if that's true that the Noynoy and Villar votes are being given to Teodoro, then there is a conspiracy.
Mm-mm.
So,
do you feel this is pro Guibo Teodoro, what is happening?
If that's what Remulla says, maybe for the first time I will agree with him. I believe that the Guibo Teodoro candidacy is maybe being pushed now only because Villar is really weakened already.
Okay.
That could be a possibility that they're dropping Villar and now pushing Guibo. How better way? Why isn't Guibo now vocal against this failure?
Mm-mm.
Why are myself, Aquino, and Villar really vocal against this PCOS failure? Maybe Teodoro stands to benefit.
Mm-mm.
That's the only way he can win, you know.
Okay. Now, but
the PCOS machine.
You don't feel this is far-fetched?
No, of course not. Nothing is far-fetched in our government. You have to think far-fetched. Because we have allowed them to get away with so much. In any normal country, automation this way would never have proceeded through Venezuelans. I mean, my God,
Mm-mm.
we could have gone direct to Canada. And I was already very suspicious when they removed that verification feature.
Yes, actually, CENPEG and transparency.org
yes,
are very upset that the transparency feature, which verifies who
Three.
You voted for,
yes.
was removed from the
Three
machine.
Three transparency features.
Yes, yes. What was removed? Do you remember?
Of course, the verification.
Okay.
And then they removed two other safety features. I know there were three, but when I asked Smartmatic and COMELEC, face-to-face, why they removed it,
Mm-mm.
they said it would take more time for the voters to vote. I mean, a lame excuse.
Yes, yes. Okay. Do you want some water,
no.
Senator?
So,
because alam ko, nangangampanya po kayo. You're very tired.